Self, VIP Saturdays. It's your boy, Gray Rizzy.
Superstar Jay.
And we still got the queen in the building. Yes. Remy Ma's up
in here, man.
Now, we just got out that joint. I'm not going to name no mm-hmm. names and stuff, but this young lady, I got a chance to see her at a show recently. This is Remy Ma.
Okay.
I got to see her at a show recently. And shout out to the homie French. You know, he was on the set. He brought Remy out.
Yeah.
And the energy was at one point when French was on stage,
mm-hmm.
when Remy came out and that whatever hit, that lean back hit,
and she came with the mask.
Let me tell you something. It was like pandemonium downstairs. I'm glad I wasn't on the floor for once. That was like niggas DDTing each other down there, man.
I was outside hearing it because they fucking rushed the doors before we came to the back.
So shout out to Brooklyn. You know what I'm saying? No sleep till Brooklyn, Pat.
I was in the crib, actually, right? And I had this hat that it's actually a hat, but it comes down over your face like a mask. And Pat was like, "You're really going to wear that mask?"
Like, but you do things like that. Like,
right. He like, but they're not going to be able to see your face, though.
They heard them words.
I said, but when that beat dropped and they hear my voice, it's going to be like, I don't know. I mean... So he just kept saying, like, I don't think you should do it. Then we got in the car. He's like, you know what? I'm going to tell you what's going to happen. You're going to hit or they going to kill you on Instagram.
But you know who follows you after, right, with the mask, right? Ho.
Yeah.
Right. I was like, yeah. Nobody stole my whole shine. I was like, yeah. Really? I just thought I shut it down.
Because really? Hope had it in probably in the truck. Yeah. And he was like, yo, Remy, can't. Oh, word. Let me get that.
Nah.
Go back to the truck and get that.
Now,
it was the day before Halloween.
Now, let me tell you something. I always say Remy's ahead of her time. Mm-hmm. You know, when we were doing our project, and she's always been a part of social media. So I knew when she came home, just the whole social media, the countdown, I think that brought it bigger. People were mm-hmm. getting hyped. You know, you was getting the drops. I didn't do a drop, but I was cool with it. Mm-hmm. It was cool. But
why did you get that?
I don't know, man. I got to talk to Pat. But, you know what I'm saying, it was the drop. So you was hyped for the countdown. And then we go back to when we was doing the whole Jesus Christ project that she was probably the first person that was doing these videos before any of these rappers, just doing regular mixtape songs on videos.
Nice.
We was filming videos. Shout out to, Rick Cordero. He's so Hollywood now, you know what I mean? But we was doing guerrilla shooting.
This is part of the reason why.
Remy could tell you, when we did the whole Jesus Christ thing, she wanted to be, because she used to do things like just even the mask, and Pat will tell you, she'll say some crazy shit. You're like, nah, Remy, we can't do that. She's like, yo, let's go to the beach, and I'm going to be on a cross and rap.
Wow.
I'm going to be on top. I'm like, are you kidding me?
They called the cops. They thought we was having a seance, like some devil. They was like some devil.
They part of a cult. We got to get them out of here.
It was crazy. But it came out hot when we finished.
It
came out dope.
Where did we find the two crosses? I think we just walked around and looked for something.
Somehow we made it. I don't know what. I know it was something crazy.
Yeah.
But I know my we needed like an outfit that looked like we just ripped the sheet up and tied it around. We was working.
And I think you had the things in your eyes mm-hmm. and all that too. But you know, just getting back to that, like now you see that it's a different time now that everybody's doing it themselves.
Yeah, everybody's doing it.
So is it easier for you now that you're saying, like, I've been doing this?
Right. I mean, like that's something that I'm used to, but now I want to do different things.
Mm-hmm.
So I have some ideas that I'm going to, with this mixtape, to be exact, mm-hmm. you know, I want to do a couple, if not all, the visuals for the records. It's only 11 records on me.
That's a lot of visuals, though.
I mean, but we could do it. It can happen.
Yo, talking about the mixtape, I see a lot of familiar names on it on here right here. And, you know, a lot of times you don't get this type of production on a mixtape. I see you went back with the home team with Sean C and LV. Shout out to Loud and that, you know, that connection with Pun.
Those are my guys.
Ron Browns.
Mm-hmm.
Kept it, you know, DITC with, you know, Buck Wild and shit like that. How was it to get everybody together on the project?
Well, some of the records, like, I had, like, beats that I had, and I knew what I wanted to do with them already.
Mm-hmm.
And then there were situations, like, with Browse, for instance, like, your Ram. I was like, yo, I'm doing something. I need some beats. I need to start making some music. This is before I actually told him that I was doing a mixtape, and he had sent me, like, three joints. because that's I feel like that's my, if you have to send me more than three and I don't like any, it's just a problem. So he sent me three, and the one that I pick is the one that I like. And that was it. Like, he just sent in, and we didn't speak. He asked me to do a record. I told him I'm working on something. As soon as I get a chance, I'm going to do it.
Yeah.
So I guess he's seen, like, you know, the blog saying that my mixtape was about to come out the next day. And he goes, he calls me, he goes, so I didn't make the mixtape. What's that? You want to be on the mixtape? He said, hell yeah, I want to be on the mixtape. So I said, then you on the mixtape. He says, well, what's the name of the song so I know when it dropped, which one it is? Like, I was like, it's called I'm Around. He's like, I got the title track. Oh, my like, God.
Oh,
like,
yeah, he like, did that. Yeah. That's one of my favorite records.
Ross did that. Thank you. I just think that everybody, like, it's also certified. He's from Philly. He did a lot of tracks on there. I worked with him a lot before I left, and he's just like anything I need. Like, I've recorded, I still record. Well, now I have Pav. He stepped his game up. Pav knows how to record.
Oh, Pav, you know how to record now? Like,
oh, shit.
Not only does he know how to record, he's like, he's reigns with the iron fist. Like,
fucking Pap Gordy over here, man.
I think you need to do that over. I don't feel the energy now. I'm being there like, yo, my G.
You don't do it over.
Control S. I can save it right this minute.
Right.
So,
right.
But you know, we record it and then we send it out to Philly, and my guy certified. He'll mix it and send everything back. Like, he just has this sound that I love.
Mm-hmm.
And once he's done with the mix, it's just crazy. And he's so ill with that. It doesn't even have to be. He does his beats that he sends as well, but he'll do everybody else's. So he's, you know, some people are biased. Like, well, I didn't do the beats. Whatever. Like, he goes 150% with everything, and I just think that everything just came together the way I needed to. A lot of times I was having conflicts of issues with people on my team because they felt that I should have brought in all my favorites and friends that, you know, are
not yet.
And that's how I felt. I felt you know, I can always call them. You know, it's nothing. Right. But also, everybody hasn't heard me in so long, mm-hmm, that I just wanted them to just to give them me.
There's no features on this mixtape.
Oh,
no.
Yes, there is. There's one.
Pat, right? Pat is on there. We did over the joint that we did at BET, since everybody liked this so much. I thought it'd be dope, like, if we put it in a song format. And Tez Smooth killed it.
Absolutely. Like, shout out to Tez Smooth. That's the homie.
Oh, he's so dope, right? Like, yeah. He puts these things together. And I thought that was great. But besides that, I think that what I had in mind,
mm-hmm,
to do was to just, you know, but for everybody who was going to say, you know, she's all right. Yeah, she, you know, she went in on a Cali dream when she came home. That was cool. I mean, yeah, she killed the hot nigga shit better than everybody that got on it.
Here we go.
You know, I'm just telling you what people are saying.
Yeah.
I'm not saying this is how I feel, even though it is how I feel. I'm just telling you what people are saying.
Mm-hmm. Nah, you killed the hot nigga.
I'm saying it. But then, you know, they'll say all that and they'll be like, you know, but, you know, what's her shit going to sound like? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I didn't want them to be able to, like, oh, of course it's hot. She has, you know, this person and that person, that person, that person.
Yeah.
And they're all flaming right now. So I refrained from that, and I just gave them me for 41 minutes. And
for free, too. Because, you know, a lot of people, man, I'll shout to Money Nails. I talk to a lot of artists now, and mm-hmm, it'd be artists with no type of buzz, and they be like, yo, I'm dropping an EP. And I'm like, for what? Like, who the fuck is buying your shit? Like, you know what I mean? This new EP thing. You know, I talk to Self all the time. He says sometimes it's good, but I just feel like an EP is for artists that's just not hot yet, so they got to drop something.
I mean, I feel like I could have dropped the album if I wanted to.
Mm-hmm.
I'm actually decided to put out another project probably before my album and call it like We Around.
Okay.
Like, and then I'll
hosted
do,
by Superstar Jay.
And then I'll do all the I'll do all the features with songs that people like, you know, and then it'll be like part two to this one. It'll be like We Around.
Nice. Have you chosen a home yet? Is this still independent or what?
Because
I know they're
free agent.
I know
right
they're coming at you, Rem. I know they're coming at you.
It's the receptiveness is great and the attention is
I like
great.
The humbleness but right I now. this is great.
I like that one.
I think that I need to be comfortable.
Mm-hmm.
Not just monetary wise, but you know, in my creativity, I need to have creative control, and I need to see something in the future. Because a lot of times, you know, you could be hot right now, you have a hot record now, and they want to give you, you know, this large sum of money, and then you see these same people next year because they couldn't make another record,
yeah.
And it's a job, it's over for them. Like, I need somebody that understands that how this business is and how it's so fickle that, mm-hmm. all right, even if this record didn't work, we're going to do something else. Like, people don't give you second chances anymore. Like, I'm blessed right now to even be sitting here talking to you guys,
yeah.
on my second chance. So I don't want to just jump into any situation because it seems like a good idea right now. I need whatever I do to seem like a good idea 5 years from now.
We got the phones jumping.
Yeah,
we got,
it's the,
you know,
Remy Ma hour.
Exactly,
you know,
we
doing,
man.
A whole hour with you. So
okay.
But let's get into some records. You pick something that you want to hear right now off the mixtape.
Let's say Go and Go Off.
Go and Go Off?
Hard joint.
Let's get it. Let's get it. VIP.
Yeah.